Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome to Brighton Lights, Latest TV's weekly What's On show. I'm Joe Fuller, editor of Latest 7 magazine, and my personal highlights this week are Colin Stetson, British Science Festival, and Mario and Rabbids. I'll be covering highlights in film, music, comedy, stage, events, and gaming, so there's hopefully something for everyone. Patty Cake was picked up by Fox Searchlight at Sundance, and it's easy to see why from the trailer. It looks like a feel-good, indie, follow-your-heart kind of tale that we've seen before, but its crowd-pleasing story beats have divided critics.
Gorgeous.
You boss bitch.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I hope to still be working for you, sir.
Your pen game is ridiculous.
You have notebooks full of songs, Pete. How badly do you want this?
You don't have the musical bone in your body, and you sure as hell can't sing. What kind of music are we talking about here?
I've been rapping.
Rapping?
Rhyming, I'm singing, you know?
Yo, Dumbo! Get out the street!
Where's the kid with the glaucoma?
This is it.
If you enjoyed the 2001 film Lara Croft's Tomb Raider or Con Air or The Expendables 2, then you might well enjoy Stratton by the same director, Simon West. Dominic Cooper aims to track down an international terrorist's cell, and Draco Malfoy's in it too.
We have a lethal weapon right there from Downing Street to Washington. Millions could die.
Go, go, go!
Someone once asked Napoleon about his battle plans. He said, show up and see what happens.
Mackenzie Crook of Detectorists and The Office fame stars in Eat Locals, a tale about 8 vampire overlords shedding blood at an important meeting. It is the directorial debut of Jason Fleming, who had a prominent part in Lock, Stock and 2 Smoking Barrels.
Come in, 18.
You have a visual on our target.
We have a positive sighting.
Hi, everyone. This is Sebastian.
Second squad, hold your position.
Sebastian, close your eyes.
Go, take him down. Do it now.
Colonel, we have a problem.
You have no idea.
These things are an abomination. They need to be wiped from the face of this earth.
Vampires with machine guns. It's not allowed.
The night is ours.
That was here when we moved in.
Jane Goldman, writer of films such as The Great Kick-Ass and The Woman in Black, has penned this murder mystery thriller, The Limehouse Golem. Bill Nighy, Olivia Cooke and Sam Reed star.
At Ratcliffe Highway, he slaughtered a household. The previous week, a prostitute.
And the golem's a madman.
Even madness has its own logic.
Inspector Kildare. I may have found an eyewitness in Limehouse, sir.
I can't tell you what I know.
Just assist me. I promise I won't let anything happen to you. Who was here on September the 24th?
There were 4 men that day.
John Cree.
Dan Leno.
George Gissing.
Karl Marx.
The newspaper said it was your first murder case.
The Yard is setting me up as a scapegoat. The public want blood. The Golem provides it. He who observes spills no less blood than he who inflicts the blow.
I've seen Colin Stetson before, and he's a brilliant live performer, utilizing techniques such as circular breathing and clicking keys to create a hypnotic, captivating sound. He's performed with an array of artists ranging from Tom Waits to Godspeed You Black Emperor, and his Duke of York show should be great. Alt-J are a great pop band with strong albums, so a Brighton Centre date is something to look forward to. I enjoy the simplicity and clarity of the keyboards, bass, guitars and drums, as well as their varied sound, ranging from baroque pop to more funky rock. Band of Horses are a fine indie band and are heading to the Delawarr Pavilion for an exclusive UK venue gig. We're going to play you a clip of early song, The Funeral, to get you in the right widescreen anthem kind of mood. Katie Crutchfield, aka Waxahachie, released a fantastic album earlier this year called Out in the Storm. Delving into a messy relationship with strong songs and big choruses, give it a few listens before going to her Comedia gig this Thursday. Kiss on my lips, starts to feel Enter Shikari are going on their biggest ever tour, including a date at Brighton Centre. No doubt you'll get to hear this track, Supercharge, featuring grime star Big Nasty. Lower Than Atlantis and Asteroid Boys are supporting. I Love You, Honey Bear was a solid Elton John aping album released in 2015 and follow-up Pure Comedy built on that popularity with even more critical acclaim. Here's a clip of the distinctive video for Total Entertainment Forever. The Oculus Rift, after Mr. and the Mrs. finished dinner and the dishes. Wise Blood is supporting Father John Misty, and she's way better than him, in fact, which makes the show a generous double bill. Her chamber pop ballads are great. There's a sparse quality and elegant Beach Boys-esque orchestration to her work, as you can hear in this track, Seven Words. I want you most in the moment. Faust are an amazing krautrock band that utilized improvisation techniques from jazz. They released some stunning albums in the early 70s that you should listen to, and this two-night residency at Lewis Constitutional Club will see them improvise with hand-picked local musicians. That's all for part one. Don't go away because we have comedy, events and gaming after the break.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment. Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome back to Brighton Lights Part 2. I'm Joe Fuller and I'm now going to tell you about more great shows in and around Brighton. Joe Pasquale brings his latest show to Worthing, promising to explain why the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse will be arriving on My Little Ponies and what Action Man held with his gripping hands. He's marking 30 years in comedy this year and still going strong.
Taken off my back. Look at the size of that. Can you believe? So listen, I've got some advice for you tonight. Like, if you're ever feeling unwell, if you've got a cold, the flu, a nasty rash, all you've got to do is cover yourself in margarine, go to the doctors and go, oh, I can't believe it's not better. And that'll solve it, right? Because this, you don't know this, but this is the second show that I've done today. Right? I did one this afternoon on the way up here today, right? At an old age pensioners club, right? Now, I knew that was going to be old because it was an old age pensioners club. But I didn't think they were going to be this old. Like, these people were so old. When they was at school, there was no history lessons then, right? It was called Current Affairs. So I thought, I'll start me to have a knock-knock joke. So I went, knock-knock, and they all went, not until you show us some form of identification. It was a complete nightmare. So.
Mrs. Barbara Nice is taking up headlining duties at gay-friendly monthly night Bent Double. She's joined by award-winning Larry Dean, turning Glasgow tough nut stereotypes on their head. And further support comes from Harriet Dyer.
I did that, man. The first time I came down here, right, I got off the train, right, and I went to buy a can of Iron Brew. And and I thought I may as well bring a bit of a stereotype to the capital city, because I was down here selling heroin. But I went to the shop, right, and this is probably happens to everyone. I went to the shop, right, and the can said 50 pence on it. And when I took it up to the counter, the guy went, that's 60 pence. And I went, yeah, but it says 50p on the can. And he went, yeah, but it's actually 60. I was like, all right, this man is just making up inflation as he goes along. So I thought, right, it's not a big deal. So I just handed the guy a 50 pence piece. That's where he got really aggressive about the situation. He went, this is the third time you're being told it is 60 pence. And I went, yeah, but that coin says 50p on it, but it's actually 60.
Thanks so much. Deliso Chaponda, who reached the final of Britain's Got Talent, headlines Crater Comedy Club this Friday. The Malawian comedian has also landed a new stand-up comedy radio show on Radio 4, so this is a good chance to see him at a smaller venue while you still can.
So, Chaponda, as you said, I am from Malawi. Yes, from Malawi, and I've been living in the UK now 7 years, and I still do not fit in. And England is legitimately a nation of complainers. Everybody hates their jobs. They hate their weather. Biggest complaint is financial crisis. Financial crisis. I'm from Africa. What are you talking about? How dare you overprivileged call that a crisis? Where's UNICEF? Where is Bono? You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over London tossing fish and chips out the window.
The Friday night Crater Comedy Club will be emceed by Mike Gunn, and Rich Wilson plus Raymond and Mr. Timpkins will also feature. Raymond and Mr. Timpkins offer something different to a typical comedy club evening, with silly visual comedy as you can see in the following clip. The British Science Festival is being co-hosted by the University of Brighton and the University of Sussex, with events held in the city centre and the Falmer campuses. There's a huge range of events you can check out at britishsciencefestival.org. And here's some highlights from last year's festival in Swansea.
3, 2, 1.
They're absolutely loving the very compelling way science is being communicated.
We do want to reach out, we do want to make clear science is everywhere.
I have OCD and I'd always wanted to write a book.
And they started to cry for mercy.
It was really nice to have people who were like way up there, the top of their field, but be able to understand what they were talking about.
I went to a fantastic talk today, 10 of us cancer choir. It made me so emotional.
You go into science because it's interesting, it's fun.
Zippo Circus is coming to town, including the popular Jiggets, who are Brazilian motorbike daredevils in a scary globe of death. There will also be horses, knife throwing, trapeze, and renowned ringmaster Norman Barrett, MBE. Brighton Speed Trials is returning to Madeira Drive, where over 200 cars and motorbikes line up to take a timed run, reaching some very high speeds.
Time for all these to see me quicker. Let's hit it on
Star cast is coming to the Theatre Royal Brighton next week in The Wedding Singer. John Robbins of Avenue Q fame, Cassie Compton from X Factor, Ray Quinn from Dancing on Ice, and Ruth Maddock from Heidi High star in the musical based on Adam Sandler's 1998 film.
Love is what I do!
Hi, welcome to sunny London on this beautiful summer day. We're here doing a photo shoot for the UK tour of The Wedding Singer.
Hi, I'm Ray Quinn and I'm playing the part of Glenn in The Wedding Singer. Today's very exciting, obviously it's a photo shoot, first photo shoot, meeting the whole cast and the team of course.
Hello, my name is Ruth Maddock and I play Grandma Rosie. Song
6 years ago. Hi, I'm Roxanne Pallett. I'm playing Holly in The Wedding Singer, and we're here today to do the promo shoot.
I'm really looking forward to this production. You know, doing a photo shoot like this really gets the juices going. I wrote that tune goes like this.
Oh, when it's your wedding. Nintendo have trusted Ubisoft with a new Mario game which sees the plumber cross over with their Raving Rabbids franchise. The game is a turn-based tactics RPG that can be played in short bursts, perfect for Switch sessions on the go.
Together we stand. Together we stand.
The Yakuza series never really took off in the West, but Sega are trying to make up for that with a remake of the original PlayStation 2 game. The new version improves the resolution and loading times, and also includes additional content to explain some of the more confusing plot points. Everybody's Golf combines deep golf mechanics with a more arcadey visual style and soundtrack. There will also be character customization, online play, fishing, buggy racing, and treasure hunting too. The PS4 launch title, Knack, was a platforming beat-em-up that was widely panned for terrible gameplay and a lackluster story. The makers are trying to make up for it, however, with God of War's writer on board, parries, charge moves, and special co-op abilities which look like they might improve the experience.
Stop. Whatever it is, I'm in. Awesome.
I'm impressed.
Little trick I taught him.
That's all for this week. Thank you for watching. If you have any shows that you'd like to be considered for a mention on Brighton Lights, then as always, you can email me at editorial@thelatest.co.uk.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.